Hello friends, today I am going to describe teaching aptitude part 6. If you like this video, kindly share and subscribe. First question: when the children become mischievous and disobedient in the classroom, the teachers should examine option A, home background of the students, B, influence of outside elements in the class, C, teaching methods and subject knowledge, C, co-curriculum and other attraction in the school. Here option C is correct, teaching method and subject knowledge. Next question: if a parent approaches the teacher to be some favor of his or her word in the examinations, the teacher should option A, try to help him, B, ask him not to talk in those terms, C, refuse politely and firmly, D, ask him rudely to go away. Here option C is correct, refuse politely and firmly. Next question: the academic performance of students can be improved if parents are encouraged to option A, supervise the work of their wards, B, arrange the extra tuition, C, remain unconcerned about it, D, interact with teachers frequently. Here option D is correct. Next question: the purpose of national education policy is A, universalization of primary education, B, vocationalization of education, C, to review the education, D, to give equal opportunity of education to all. Here option C is correct, to review the education. Next question: the idea of basic education was propounded by A, Dr. Zakir Hussain, B, Dr. Rajendra Prasad, C, Mahatma Gandhi, D, Rabindranath Tagore. Here Mahatma Gandhi is the correct answer. Next question: the aim of education should be option A, to develop vocational skills in the students, B, to develop social awareness in the students, C, to prepare the students for examinations, D, to prepare the students for practical life. Here option D is correct, to prepare the students for practical life. Next question: family is the main agency of option A, informal education, B, formal education, C, non-formal education, D, none of the above. Here informal education is the correct answer. Next question: the main purpose of new education policy is option A, to provide equal opportunities of education to all, B, to improve the whole education system, C, to link education with employment, D, none of the above. Here option B is correct, to improve the whole education system. Next question: National Council of Educational Research and Training was established in option A, 1961, B, 1962, C, 1963, D, 1964. Here option A is correct, 1961. Next question: the main aim of National Council for Teachers Education is option A, to open colleges of education, B, to promote research in education, C, to maintain standards in college of education, D, to provide grant to college of education. Here option C is correct, to maintain standards in college of education. Next question: National Literacy of Mission was established in option A, 1996, B, 1988, C, 1999, D, 2000. Here option B is correct, 1988. Next, SITE stands for option A, System for International Technology and Engineering, B, Satellite Instructional and Television Experiment, C, South Indian Trade Estate, D, none of these. Here option B is correct, Satellite instructional television experiment. Next question. Education TV was first introduced in India. Option A, 1961, B, 1959, C, 1968, D, 1961. Here, 1968 is the correct answer. Next question. CHEER stands for option A, Children Enrichment Education Through Radio, B, Child Health Education Electronic Recording, C, Children for Engineering and Energy Recruitment, D, none of these. Here option A is correct, Children Enrichment Education Through Radio. Next question. By which of the following methods the true evolution of the student is possible? Option A, evolution at the end of the course, B, evolution twice a year, C, continuous evolutions, D, formative evolutions. Here option C is correct, continuous evolution. Next question, which test is carried out to determine the ability of a learner? Option A, attitude, B, aptitude, C, achievements, D, scholarship. Here aptitude is the correct answer. Next question, which type of evaluation is carried out at the end of the course of study? A, summative, B, assessment, C, formative, D, both A and B. Here summative evaluation is the answer. Next question, summative evaluation is used for which of the following purpose? Option A, to monitor students' progress during the learning process, B, primary to clarify or grade students, C, to find out what a student's interest and work habits are, D, to assign students to specific learning group. Here option B is correct, to clarify or grade students. Next question. The most important indicator of quality of education in an educational institute is option A, infrastructure facilities of a school, B, classroom system, C, textbook and teaching learning material, D, student achievement level. Here D is the correct answer, student achievement level. Next question. To raise the standard of education, it is necessary option A, to evaluate students continuously, B, to give high salary of teachers, C, to revise curriculum, D, to make good school building. Here option is the correct answer, to evaluate students continuously. Next question. What type of test is most effective when trying to test memorization? Option A, true false, B, multiple choice, C, fill in the blanks, D, both B and C. Here option D is correct, both B and C. Next question. The most significant approach of evolution is option A, continuous and comprehensive evaluations, B, conductive objective term end examinations, C, maintaining cumulative record of students, D, semester system evaluations. Here option A is correct, continuous and comprehensive evaluations. Thank you all. Visit again in next video.